हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ सेल इंजरी विच इज़ नोन एज पैथोजेनेसिस इन द पैथोफिजियोलॉजी। इंजरी टू सेल हैव मैनी कॉजेज। मैक्रोमोलिक्यूल्स, एंजाइम्स एंड ऑर्गेनेल्स विद इन द सेल आर क्लोजली रिलेटेड, इंटरडिपेंडेंट व्हेन द लोकेशन ऑफ द सेल इंजरी आर वेल डिफाइंड। स्पेशल केस प्लेस इन द ऑक्सीजन रोल। Oxygen plays a central role in the cell injury. If lack of oxygen is there, it leads to ischemia. Is the basically cause of pathogenesis of cell injury. Reduced activated oxygen species such as Clostridium perfringens, which is anaerobic bacteria, have elaborate phospholipids which attack phospholipids in the cell membrane. These are called as free radical species, cause lipid oxidation and other deleterious effects on cell structure, which leads to the cell injury. Next is cell damage. The effect of hypoxia in the aerobic respiration cells involving oxidation phosphorylation reaction in mitochondria. The generation of ATP slows down or stops when the cell damages, or this causes failure of active membrane sodium pump. This effect the accumulation of sodium intracellular and fusion of potassium out of the cell. It produces cellular swellings, means cell swells due to isosmotic gain of water. This stage is reversible if oxygen is restored. If ischemia persists, the irreversible injury may be occur. Next is nuclear damage. The decrease in cellular ATP, increase in adenosine monophosphate stimulates the enzyme phosphofructokinase glycolysis to maintain the cell's energy source by generating ATP from glycogen. The glycogen gets rapidly depleted and causes histological changes. Glycolysis results in accumulation of lactic acid and inorganic phosphate from hydrolysis of phosphate ester. It results in the reduce of pH and glycogen, which results in clumping of chromatin, and this stage is reversible if oxygen is restored. Then is ribosome damage. This process involves oxidative phosphorylation. This process also involves decrease in ATP, which results in detachment of ribosome from granular endoplasmic reticulum ER and dissociation of polysomes into monosomes. If hypoxia continues, it will lead to increased membrane permeability and diminished mitochondrial functions. This mitochondria will appear normal, slightly swollen. The endoplasmic reticulum is dilated and entire cell is marked as swollen, which is leads to apoptosis or irreversible injury. Next is mitochondrial damage. Mitochondrial damage occurs to a cell when ATP levels and pH level both decreases as a result of anaerobic metabolism and lactate accumulation. ATPase dependent ion transport mechanism become dysfunctional. This is known as reversible injury. If hypoxia continues, calcium level uploads and cell keeps swelling, cell gets rupture, then there is cell death, and cell death is caused by necrotic, necroptotic, apoptotic and autophagic mechanisms. Next is morphology of cell injury. Cell is a highly structured complex of molecules, organelles, that are arranged to fulfill the routine metabolic housekeeping functions of the body. And the cell has energy needs, some transport mechanism to facilitate the import of metabolites, the export of waste products. Injury to cell results in relative disruption of, one or more of these structures. Certain injurious agents like radiations, chemicals, viruses, some bacterial and functional toxins, which stimulates and which bring changes in the cellular morphology, which can be divided and we will study. Reversible injury these are morphological changes resulting from injury to the cells are known as reversible injury. We can classify reversible injury in two types. First is cellular swelling and fatty changes. Cellular swelling appears when cells are incapable of maintaining ionic and fluid homeostasis. And fatty changes occurs when there is appearance of small or large lipid vacuoles within the cells or within the cytoplasm of the cell. And toxic injury due to fat metabolism as seen in mitochondrial cell. Fatty changes occurs in liver, which are the causes of metabolic rearrangement of intracellular accumulations. Next term is necrosis. Necrosis means death of the cell. Cell death is recognized when it undergoes sequence of morphological changes, mostly enzymatic digestion of the cell, and second is denaturation of the proteins. When the increased intracellular levels of calcium, cell leads to mitochondrial damage, phospholipase activation, and it leads to the necrosis. Next term is apoptosis. Apoptosis is a highly programmed and orderly form of cellular suicide. The different stages of apoptotic cell death start by cellular shrinkage and chromatin condensation. Organelles and nucleus fragment begin formation of apoptotic bodies, which are engulfed by neighboring cells, or you can say macrophages, and this process of engulfing is known as endocytosis or phagocytosis. The lack of release of cellular component to the extracellular fluid results in absence of inflammation, which is known as apoptosis. Next is autophagy, heterophagy, atrophy. There are cellular adaptive changes. Cell must undergo adaptation even under normal condition to overcome changes in the environment. These physiological adaptations are due to response to normal stimulation by hormones, chemical substances. Example is enlargement of breast and induction of lactation in pregnancy. The pathological adaptations undergo the same mechanism, but cell with the ability to adapt their environment in order to escape the injury. Term is atrophy. Atrophy is that condition when the cell size becomes small, when the cell of the size of the cell decreases, or you can say loss of cell substance from the cell is known as atrophy. If atrophy take place in enough number of organ cells, the complete organ gets shrink, the complete organ gets small. It is known as atrophy. It is most commonly found in heart, skeletal muscle, brains, and secondary sex organs. Example is thymus gland undergoes physiological atrophy during childhood. Next term is hypertrophy. Hypertrophy, when the size of the cells increases, which leads to increase in organ size. It is due to increased functional demand or by specific hormonal stimulation, which may occur during physiological and pathogenic conditions. Example is physiological growth of uterus during pregnancy, which involves both hypertrophy and hyperplasia. Hypertrophy is an adaptation response, which is also due to enlargement of muscles. The cells of heart, cells of kidney are particularly responsive to enlarge. Enlargement of heart is caused by dilation of cardiac chambers, and it is short-lived. The increase in cells in association with increased accumulation of proteins in cellular component like plasma membrane or mitochondria or endoplasmic reticulum, which is known as cardiac hypertrophy. Next is your term is hyperplasia. Hyperplasia is increase in number of cells resulting from increased rate of cellular division. Cellular growth is increased due to multi-step process involving the production of growth factors. Hyperplasia and hypertrophy are the terms which are both used simultaneously in tissue. Both hyperplasia and hypertrophy take place if the cells are capable of synthesizing DNA. Cardiac and skeletal muscles have no capacity नेक्स्ट टर्म इज हाइपरप्लेसिया. हाइपरप्लेसिया एंड हाइपरट्रॉफी टर्म्स आर क्लोजली रिलेटेड एंड ऑफन डेवलप साइमल्टेनियसली इन टिश्यू. बोथ हाइपरप्लेसिया एंड हाइपरट्रॉफी टेक प्लेस इन सेल्स आर कैपेबल ऑफ सिंथेसाइजिंग डीएनए. नेक्स्ट टर्म इज मेटाप्लेसिया. मेटाप्लेसिया इज द रिवर्सिबल रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ वन एडल्ट सेल बाय अनदर. एंड मेटाप्लेसिया इज सीन इन स्क्वैमस चेंज दैट अकर्स इन रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्ट इन हैबिचुअल सिगरेट स्मोक. द स्टोन इन द एक्सक्रीटरी डक्ट्स ऑफ द सलाइवरी ग्लैंड पैनक्रियाज और बाइल डक्ट्स मे कॉज रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ द नॉर्मल सिक्रेटरी कॉलमनर एपिथीलियम. डेफिशिएंसी ऑफ विटामिन ए इंड्यूस्ड एक्वस मेटाप्लेसिया इन द रेस्पिरेटरी एपिथीलियम. नेक्स्ट टर्म इज डिस्प्लेसिया. डिस्प्लेसिया अकर्स व्हेन एबनॉर्मल चेंजेस इन द साइज शेप ऑफ एंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ एडल्ट सेल विच इज रिलेटेड टू हाइपरप्लेसिया डायरेक्टली. इट इज़ कंसिडर्ड एज ट्रू अडेप्टिव प्रोसेस विच अकर्स इन मैनी चेंजेस. दीज चेंजेस आर स्ट्रांगली एसोसिएटेड विद कॉमन न्यू प्लास्टिक ग्रोथ. ऑफन आर फाउंड टू यू कैन से कैंसरस सेल्स मेनली ग्रोथ लाइक द सेल्स इन डिस्प्लेसिया आर सीन इन द पेशेंट विद कैंसर. एंड डिस्प्लेसिया कैन बी कैटेगराइज एज माइल्ड मॉडरेट और सिवियर डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द लो ग्रेड और हाई ग्रेड कंडीशंस. Thank you.